Today I want to just go over very briefly about, I guess you've heard it in a song before where it talks about that Jesus is a friend of sinners. And is that the case? Is that said in the Bible? Well, if we read that passage, you'll see that the Pharisees were the ones that were accusing Jesus of being a friend of sinners. That statement was actually an accusation by the Pharisees. They also called him a winebibber, which obviously was not true. It was false. Again, it was an accusation that the Pharisees were bringing against Jesus. But why did they call him a friend of sinners? I guess that's the question that we can ask, is why did they accuse him of that? Did Jesus go up to the sinners? Did he befriend them? Did he hang out with them? Did he go out partying or drinking with them? Obviously he didn't. What he did was he did come to save the lost. He did come to offer salvation to those that were lost. The sinners, obviously. He didn't come for those that were saved. He came for those that needed saving, that needed a savior. And so that's what Jesus did. The Pharisees saw that, but the Pharisees, as being as hypocritical as they were, wouldn't do such things. They wouldn't go up to sinners and care about their salvation. Jesus, however, did. But to call him a friend of sinners is actually incorrect. And scripture says that in John 15:14, Jesus Christ says, "You are my friends if you do what I command." If you do what I command. So you can be a friend of Jesus, but there is a condition to being his friend. You must actually obey Jesus. And so if somebody is still in rebellion, they're still in their sin, they're still sinning day after day after day, in thought, word, and deed, and they haven't come to a repentance where they've stopped their sinning, they're sorrowful, and they've come to Christ giving up their sin, then they're actually not a friend of Christ. They're just not a friend. Not according to what Scripture says and what Jesus Christ says. Jesus said, again, in John 15:14, "You are my friend if you do what I command you." So again, to clear it up, Jesus was not what the Pharisees accused him of being, a friend of sinners. He loved the people that he was ministering to. He loved everybody. He loved every sinner. He loved you and me on the cross. He showed his love for us on the cross, that we might be saved, that we might come to a saving faith, that we might come to repentance, turn to him, give up our sins. So in that sense, Jesus loves everyone, every sinner that has ever lived. Jesus has a love for those people. But you can actually love people and they can still not be your friends. We saw that on the cross while Jesus was dying. As he was suffering, as his life was slipping away, people were laughing at him, mocking at him, telling him, "If you are the Son of God, save yourself and come down from the cross." Jesus said, as we all know, he looked up to his Father and said, "Forgive them, for they know not what they do." And while he was yet dying, losing his breath, his blood, and as people were mocking him and laughing at him, he still loved them. He loved them enough to shed his blood for them. He couldn't even die in peace. As he was suffering, as his life was slipping away, and they were just mocking him, laughing at him, and he still loved them. So yes, Jesus loves you enough that he shed his blood for you, that you may come to him in repentance and live a holy and obedient life to him. So I hope that you do that today. I hope that you consider your life and the way you're living it. Let God examine your life, examine your heart, that He might find you blameless when He comes back for you.